an offering. Let's break it down. Same shed, different shed. Same rituals for open religions. Now, what is Amita offering on the other hand? He's offering the real good. I'm talking about cold, hard cash. And cash, my friend, is king. And I'm not talking about just a few rupees here and there. I'm talking about Tony Montana, lovers of cash. And drugs.
No, you're not. Save me.
I'm so happy to see you.
popularity contest. I could have called that one. I saw it coming. Honestly, what's the ball offering? Let's break it down. Same shit, different day. Ancient ritual for Okie religion. Now, what is Amita offering on the other hand? She's offering the real goods. I'm talking about cold, hard cash. And cash, my friend, is king. And I'm not talking about just a few rupees here and there. I'm talking about Tony Montana levels of cash. And drugs. Oh, there's going to be so many drugs, guys. It's going to be a party. I'm seriously going to get so wasted on fucking Dawn and Sheena Shash. It's going to be amazing. Somebody better bring the hash. I'm telling you that right now.
Amita, I'm in the north.
The north? I haven't seen Ukash in years. Listen, there's a golden box cell there. They're good people. Ukash is just north of the bridge, and this cell, they know the area better than anyone. By the bridge.
They're waiting for you downstairs. Ajay, thank you for reuniting us with the Golden Path in the south.
You can tell Amita and Sabal we are ready to fight. They have targets picked.
Home.
No! It's my family.
Very charming. Ooh, this. Oh, I like this. Is this mahogany?
And look at you. A lovely couple to match a lovely home. Very salt of the earth. You know, I was told that if I ever wanted to experience the hospitality of Utkarsh, I had to visit the Ramas. Oh, we questioned everyone, too. And everyone said the exact same thing. They are the friendliest. They will talk to anyone. To anyone, I say. To everyone, they say. Well, they were so emphatic that I decided I had to see it for myself. He's cute. You see, I wanted to warn you.
Warn us, sir?
Yes. Now, I'm not sure if you've heard, but it's come to my attention that there are some very disreputable people around. And I'm concerned that these people, these terrorists, well, they might take advantage of your hospitality. ruin your wonderful reputation. And we wouldn't want that to happen now, would we?
No, sir.
No. Well, would you allow me to protect you? To ensure your reputation? Please, yes, Kingman. Your wish is my command. I'm so glad we could agree on this. Well, I won't take up any more of your time. This should only take a moment. And they say I've lost touch with my subjects.
No! They'll kill you!
I'm getting pagan. Amita! I found Pagan! I'm on his heels!
Okay, you could end it right now!
I know!
Did you miss me? Oh, wait, yes, you did.
Pagan? I just killed you.
No, no, you just ruined a perfectly good body double with hair loss. Do you know how expensive he was to make? He wasn't even Asian, for Christ's sake. He was from Melbourne, I think. His only crime was being born with fabulous cheekbones. Whose picture do you think's on the money? No matter, what's done is done. I suppose next time it'll just be you and me.
Ajay, you're just in time. Pagan's broadcast is starting.
What's this about?
No clue, brother. But we're going to find out.
Good people of Kirat. I'm sure you will all be delighted to know that the reports of my death are completely and utterly inaccurate. I am alive, and all is right in the world. But life brings change, and I implore you, Kirat, to look to my example and see it as the positive influence it is. Change requires strength, and it is a strength that I know all of you possess. Now, I recently experienced change within my own organization. Miss Noor and Paul Deplure, after years of dedicated service, have decided to move on. I'm sure you will all join me in wishing them well in their future endeavors. But like them, we must look forward, not back. The attempt on my life is nothing more than a symptom of resistance to change. Rest easy. For Yuma Lao, my trusted commander-in-chief, who oversees our mining operations at the KEO facility, stands between me and any would-be assassin. She would rather die than see any harm come to me. Go ahead, I challenge you. Put her resolve to the test. To summarize, change is good. Embrace it. Your king is alive. Rejoice. And Yuma stands like a sentinel, waiting. Bring it on.
Sounds like he's calling us out.
The mines. You know what to do.
I've spent a lot of my life apologizing for Yuma's first impressions. She has a remarkable ability to make consistently terrible introductions. I'd love for you two to meet on better terms. She really has been the driving force behind most of my successes. She forges deals with my international buyers. She polices Noor and Deplure. She even finds time to run my army. Well, that is until her recent obsession with Kirati superstition took a hold of her. She thinks I don't know about the expedition she's been sending up the mountains looking for magical paintings or whatever it is. I'm as open as the next fellow about negligible losses for the sake of employee morale, but only so many pins can go missing from the stationery cupboard before someone has to lose a hand.
The rebels to thank for clearing the army out of their checkpoint.
It's certainly a lot easier without the Pagan men and everyone on the Yuma.
Thank you. Sends a boy like you to kill me? After everything I did for him! Before your whore of a mother came along, he was fearless! Nobody could stand up to him!
Then your mother...
Yeah. lied to myself. I thought he would get better. He had to get better. But no. What is broken stays broken. It stays weak. But Pagan will not break me.
Got me.
What the hell?
Let's stop playing this game.
Do what Pagan would never do himself. Time to kill you and mix your mother's ass in pig slaw.
Oh.
Amida, Yuma's dead.
Oh, you killed the demon of Durgesh. Don't worry, Ajay. Pagan is next.